out on her farm, and we never knowed what it was called. Some say it's a flower, and some say it's a weed. Well, I never gave it much thought. Then one day I was out there talking to my brother, and I reached down for a weed to chew on. Things got fuzzy and things got blurry, and then everything was gone. I didn't know what it was, but I knew it beat the hell out of sniffing burlap. When I finally came to, there's my brother Bill. He says, now what's wrong with your eyes? I said, I don't know, I'm just chewing on this here weed. He says, well, let me give it a try. It took the rest of that day and most of the night to try and find my brother Bill. I caught up with him about 5 o'clock the next morning, and he was naked, singing on a windmill. Said he flew up there. Had to fly up and get him down because he was half crazy. Well, smoking them weeds became kind of a habit around that park. We never seen no harm. We thought it was kind of handy. You take a trip and never leave the farm. One little hit off the wildwood flower, pretty soon you're back there behind the wild animals. Well, all good things got to come to an end, and that's the same with the wildwood weed. A man came out from Washington, spiders turned as white as a sheet. Well, he burned and he dug and he dug and he burned, and he killed all our cute little weeds. Then he got his truck and he drove away. We just smiled and we waved, sitting on them sacks of seeds. Thank you.